Hello, I am Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic, and in this video we are going to explore the rather unconventional lens Canon RF-S 7.8mm. It was created in cooperation with Apple, and it's designed to record so-called spatial video. So far, only iPhones have been able to do that, and that's why it's really worth testing. So, let's start playing. What you'll see in this video. First, we'll briefly summarize the key specifications of this lens and what it was actually created for. But very quickly, we'll start to map out the broader context, because it's really easy to get lost in all those complicated terms. What is important to know? That lens continues the lineup of Canon's 3D lenses. I've tested some before, but this one is interesting because it's the first lens which is able to record so-called spatial video. The basic principle would be that you just record the footage, then you import it into what you can see here, which is called EOS VR Utility, in which you are able to do some basic stuff and basically check what you have. One of the options for export is the spatial video. Once you do it, you are able to edit the footage in Final Cut Pro, which is quite important software for video editing on Macs. And then you can hit that magical button and you are able to send it to Apple Vision Pro, to the futuristic tool which should open new worlds of 3D. And I know that probably now you are slightly lost. Let us decode what all these terms mean. First is the spatial video as such. So, from iPhone 15 Pro to all versions of iPhone 16, you are able to record something which is called spatial video. It looks like a very ordinary one, but if I open it in some special software, like here, this is the Final Cut Pro, we'll get to it, I am able to see the 3D tricks. Like I can turn on something which is called anaglyph, where the 3D information is actually encoded into two colors. And if you now have these very ordinary blue and red glasses, you should see the peacock in 3D. And this is quite important because it shows us what Apple would love us to do. Not in anaglyph, of course, but simply in the future, Apple believes that you will really love to have the 3D world in your glasses, in your devices. What is the role of the new lens in this game? The new lens is the first device which is able to record spatial video. I should note that now we are in something which is called EOS VR Utility. It's a free software made by Canon, and it gives us the power to play with the footage like I do right now. What really matters is that we have three options, three export formats, and one of them would be the 3D Theater, which you can see here, and it's when you have two different recordings for both of your eyes, and you're able to combine it, and you're able to see this in 3D. But then we have the 3D Spatial, which means that now we are moving towards the Apple new world. The main difference between what the Apple as such does and what Canon does is that it's cropped. So it's a square. And here we go. This is Final Cut Pro, into which I imported the footage from Canon's EOS VR Utility. And you can see that I am just able to work with these videos like they were just any other normal ones. And again, one lovely anaglyph, but do not get confused. You can't actually export it in that format. Anaglyph is one of the options how to see the stereoscopic recording. I can, of course, let the footage to be very normal one, very ordinary one like this one, or I can hit black and white and you can play with this as long as you want. What really matters is that this is a great option to illustrate what's happening in background. And the magic is here. If I want to export that, you see that I'm able to export it for Apple Vision Pro. And what should be mentioned though is that, of course, in the future there would be many more Vision Pros and many more Apple's tools like that. What matters is that Apple really wants us to believe that in future you'll have some cheaper versions of that, and then that when you record that footage, you'll be able to view it in 3D. One more important term which might be confusing for you. We jump back to EOS VR Utility and let's go back to these export formats. You see that if I use recordings from the new lens, we have these three options. 3D Theater, it means a traditional 3D option. Then we have the 3D Spatial, we've played with that. And then we have that 3D 180, which is a format called VR 180. And it's really important because these are recordings made in another of the Canon's lenses. I already tested it before, but it's important to stress the differences and similarities. The similarity, of course, is that this is, again, the 3D world we are in. The difference is that if I open it and play with this, I'm able to export it only to that format. So I'm not able to use the older 3D lenses made by Canon for spatial video at the moment. Maybe in the future, but at the moment it's not possible. But if I upload it to YouTube, you see that there is this fantastic option, that very strange button, which allows me to not only to see the video, but I'm able to look down, look up, I'm able to zoom to the details, and it's quite impressive. One more example, which is quite nice, you can see that I can study the roots of the trees, for instance, or I can just look up, I can look right, left, or see what the bird would be doing here. And yes, it's just impressive. And for some product presentations, that could really make a big sense. And of course, we are able to do the same with the peacocks. There are so many details we are able to study. Yes, I'm not sure if I would be using that too much, but it's important to explain how that works and how it is different from the thing we are talking about today. The logical question is, am I able to do the same with the new lens? Yes and no. Yes, because I am able to record that. I am able to use that wheel to move it there and back, but it doesn't really make much sense because the angle is simply not there. It's not 180. So it means that the footage from fisheye would serve mostly for recording VR 180s. Maybe in the future it will change, but not at the moment. Whereas when we have the recordings from the new lens, as we already mentioned, you have three options for export, including the magical spatial video. So thank you so much for your attention. I hope you like the peacocks and you got some inspiration. It really opens up new opportunities. Take care. I'm Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic.